jacket, Charlie? I found it in the closet downstairs.
Hey, you can answer the question with MJ.
Thank you. Thank you.
right, everybody there, please take your seats, if you will, because the food is coming out.
Let's go.
going to do it again. Chorus. All of you know the words there. Yeah, sure. I'll bring you in.
But anyway.
anyways, the assignment was write a paper, a good deed. What did you do for the weekend for your mom and dad? So I got to school with the paper, and I don't know why Miss Cotney picked out mine out of everybody to read. And she's reading it, and she says, "Oh, well, you slippered the floor. That's great. You slippered the floor for your mother. What did you do? Put your slippers on and slide across the floor?" She really embarrassed the hell out of me in front of everybody, you know? But I didn't know what that was. I mean, a slipper was, instead of vacuuming, you know, I should have said it was slippery. But, you know, they didn't understand. But anyway, that's how Mom and Dad learned English, I think, from speaking English to us and we talking English back to them. Now, one second, bear with me.
What's the time of fair?
Yeah,
weeks
before winter.
What's that other story of the
hotel?
Albany Park, we've got people in the room, Sheila and Masha, we all live together. And remember Clark and Margaret's little grocery store? Little Chinese people, not little, but they're Chinese people.
Japanese.
Japanese?
We like to be called Chinese.
Excuse me, you know better than me. Well, anyways, they had a little butcher shop in the back and little aisles where, you know, I could say, I was just a client, I was just a little boy. But I remember going with Mom all the time, you know, just talking to the butcher. I don't know how they understood, but still. So one day, what another vividly part that stands out in my mind is that Mother is ready to pay, and she says, "Clark," the Japanese man, very, very nice people, Clark and Margaret. And she goes, "Clark, you know, besides all this, I need 2,000 aye and a half a gallon of milk." So the milk he understood, but the 2,000 aye, I had to interpret a little bit. But really, I think Clark did understand what Mom was talking about, I could go on and on, but I'm not going to bore you because I've been up here enough. I want to call on either Joey or Sarah. Come on up here right now if they have anything, or Willie. How about you? You got something, Willie?
I think, if I'm not mistaken, it was in the President's Boulevard.
Was it?
That's right.
See, I don't make a mistake sometimes. I got a good habit all the time, I forget. That's not my book. I say it's H. Anyway, when I came in, it was in the morning, in that little Joe, if you know.
That's me.
And
little Joe over there.
He was really little. I don't know how old he was. He was in bed, in a sneaky way, he looked out. Boy, who is that guy now? Anyway, it was a pleasure, and I really have a ticket to go back. And Leo should rest in peace in Mali, a special Mali. Even I'm related to Leo should rest in peace. She was working a lot harder, to be honest, than Leo. She said, "The only thing I got, he is nobody. You, the only guy, is a cousin." And she stopped working so much that, not that I decided, Leo find me that time a job. I was never a tailor. I used to design baby shoes. But I was a little handy, and I went there for a while, and I was working. And in the meantime, Mali, when you talk about Mali, to get ready, what is there to get ready? It's so many things that without readiness, you could tell a lot of stories. I mean, I don't want to hold your people too long. If you see it's an hour, just stop me, please. So anyway, I come one time and she, Mali said to me, "How about going to the A&P? I said, "Fine." I wasn't too crazy. I mean, after all, I didn't want to look how she spent money. I was standing in a side and she was talking to the manager. And all of a sudden, the way she told me, she said my brother, I should rest in peace, she was the manager, and he said to her, "Who's that guy? I better not talk to you too much. If your husband, I don't have a problem with your husband." So she said, "My husband, he's not my husband, he's my cousin." And right away she asked him, "Do you know anybody for him?" He said, "Yeah, I got my sister lunch." Did he give her the telephone? And she said, "Really, I got the telephone." And I wasn't even thinking, to be honest, I was scared when I came to the United States, even talk to American women. They have so many stories about American women. Right, it's honest. So I didn't want to talk. I went to the movies that I was supposed to call her up. I came home. And Mali takes the telephone without me telling anything. She said, "He or she is." I said, "Who is she?" And I start talking, and she, the way she talks, she should rest in peace. As such a Jewish, if she came to Mali, I think the way she talked the language in Jewish, she couldn't kill her, but she was talking. To talk in English to Jewish, that's a very hard thing. Anyway, I went out one time, and somehow Leah gave me that job, should rest in peace, and I was baking butter novels. It was a funny thing. I saw her one time, we went out a date, and after the date, the guys were telling me, "Didn't you go out to toy yesterday? I would recognize her." And I went to sleep, I couldn't sleep all the night. That's a true story. If you don't believe me, ask me. Anyway, so the story goes like this. I couldn't sleep all night, I was turning. Don't think I never have a girl in my life before.
No.
That would bother me.
Not you.
What do you mean?
Really?
Sure not. I never lie. I only lie if I have to, you know. So anyway, I said to myself, I went the next day to roll it, and I couldn't do a button roll. You make one stitch more to buy buttonholes. So I said to myself, I'm going to get her out of my mind. I'm going to call her tonight. I don't want to have another problem another night. She's not going to say to me, "Come." I call her up and say, "Well," I looked in the paper, the name, you know. And I said, "Would you like to go someplace?" She said, "Why? You can come to my house." And believe me, like I said, I'm not going to talk for long. After 3 months...
This is not at all. What was it got to do with
this? This was a short story. After 3 months, we were married. So this whole... Wait a minute. You cut, though. I'm not finished yet.
And we got married. After 3 months. This was... Yes, she was the first freshman. And I wanted to make, there was always something. Molly was never short of having people in the house. And for anything, and for any occasion. It didn't have to be a holiday. It didn't have to be a birthday or whatever. There was always people there. So I'm really going to make it short. I always known that this was the real cousin. Then we shouldn't know about it. My wife died. She should rest in peace. And I have no ideas. They were both looking ready. Molly, India should rest in peace. It's for somebody else to have company with me. And we got married with my wife, Nadja. And I tell you one thing. The first time she should rest in peace, she was a wonderful woman. I think you know her. It's unbelievable. And this wife, I really appreciate Molly when we talk about Molly Dean. I'm so glad I married that woman. It's like she was the real matchmaker. And that's why, no matter what, how sometimes she gets, she calls me up, I'm alone, I'm there. And nice talking to you, and I wish you many, many more years, and a happy birthday. And thank you for listening to me. Thank you, Rory.
That was really, really nice.
You know, I do have one, though. I actually have one more in here, okay?
Yes,
I got to get one more. I'm sorry, okay? 80 years comes around one time.
It's short sweet.
Mom, remember when I was just a little boy and I used to cry all the time? I don't know why. You didn't know why. I just look at my mother and cry.
It's the guilt.
The guilt or the guilt? Anyways. I look at her, and she'd look at me and say, what's the matter? Why are you crying? And I was scared to tell her why. But finally, I said, Mom, the reason I'm crying is, I think it went on for a couple months. I says, Mom, I don't want you to die. She says, what makes you think I'm going to die? I says, Mom, your hair is gray. You know, you're going to die. I says, only old people have gray hair. But, so with that, she went to Steffi and she got her hair permed, I guess, and colored. And I think the real reason, though, was for her to get that job with Velcro. It wasn't for me. Or was it, Mom? Was it for me or for Velcro? For both? Sister up here right now.
Well, we are going to do, we want everybody to talk, but we do want you to eat cake and ice cream too. So I think we're going to do a cake and ice cream.
Hey, Leo. Leo.
Good morning,
Leo. You can have a couple wishes if you want.
Lashes? Get that one. It's a trick one. Harder.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Who wants to make the first cup with their mother?
Grandma, I remember Grandma.
15 years ago? 10 years ago?
10 years ago.
10 years ago, I went to a, what are they, an open house for Velcro? Everything.
Yeah,
65th. And the place is huge. Grandma's like, this is great. And so the place, have you anybody been to Velcro?
Yeah.
It's big. And they had like hot dogs, the whole shit, they're lying, wrapping all the way around the factory down the road. And there's tents. I thought it was like a little thing. You go there and have a hot dog. Huge! They have people doing shows. Remember all the shows, people you worked with? I still have at home those wigs with glitter on it. I just didn't bring one. And they're dancing, so I took one of those. But I have coolers. I use this a lot for my landscape. I wrote my design to you. I want it back. But remember that? Yeah, you get back. Hold it. Grandma, should we walk in? And they have like roped off so it's safe for people to walk. And there's a little aisle here, there's machines and it goes now. It's you could race cars in this factory. It's huge. So you have to stand this just inside your yellow line. I guess it's for forklifts driving and stuff. Right. There's a machine. Big. What do you do, Grandma? It's not going big yet. So we're going over here. She's God damn, was that a huge machine she used? There's a ladder. She had to climb up. She says, I take the bucket. Lower here, I climb up the butt ladder, I dump it in the bottom, and out comes these little black things. What were they? Do you know what they were? I don't know what they were. Little tiny parts. The machine was like half the size of the room, I remember. Huge! And yeah, we're here. She was like this tall. And the machine was huge. And that's what I remember. That was a very funny thing I remember with Grandma. But it's a short story, but I think it was funny.
Ruben, you got another story?
It's interesting. I have spent so many years with Velcro. I do have a Velcro story. I drive a truck for a living, and Velcro is one of our customers. And so I frequented that place quite a bit. I got to be very friendly with the traffic manager. What was her name again? I forget. So I was sitting there talking to her one day, and I happened to mention to her that my aunt works upstairs. She said, what's her name? This is Mama Rothstein. She said, I know Mama Rothstein. Everybody knows Mama Rothstein. She's been here, you know, she's like an institution. I says, how about we play a little trick on her? I says, you call her boss up and tell her to come downstairs to the office. Well, so she did. What was your boss's name over there?
George.
Carlos, that's it. Okay, so Aunt calls Carlos up. And then tells her to come downstairs to the shipping office. But Mama doesn't know shipping office in this office. She knows she's being called to the office. She comes down with a scared little girl, not knowing what's up, what's down, or something like that. So why she's being called down here. I'm sitting in this little cubicle around the corner. She comes around the corner and Ann says, come on over here, son, we're here to meet you. Hi, how are you? What are you doing to me? I don't know why I come down to the office. But after that, she got over it and they had a nice visit for a little while. You remember that?
That was good.
They always gave
what?
T-shirts.
same dishes.
The dishes? Like popcorn and your dishes?
No. A plate you could collect. The guys always asked us that after the movie, we should stop and bring them a beer. This would be their reward for babysitting. Well, I really didn't like to go to a tavern to buy a beer, but I had no choice because Molly didn't want to go in, so here I go, wanting to buy 2 bottles of beer. Needless to say, the man looks at me and he says, "Who are you kidding? You can't have a beer. I'm not selling you any beer." I said, "I'm married, little girl." He said, "You could be 15 and have a little girl. Show me an ID." Nothing helped. I walked out embarrassed and hurt without the beer. I go out, I tell Molly the story. She doesn't give me a second glance, walks into the store and gets 2 beers. We go home and I was so hurt that I went down to bedtime and buy myself a beer. I hope you remember this policy. You still have to remember the good times.
Hey, there's cake.
Yeah, they're all cold.
Getting ready to face that day. She put on her lipstick,
combed her hair, and sprayed it well, so that the winds of Chicago would not affect it. She checked herself in the mirror one last time before heading out the door and was horrified at what she saw. To her shock, her hair had become as white as the driven snow. In a panic, she came to our house to ask my mother for help. My mom took her back to her house to find out what had happened. After Mom's thorough investigation, she discovered that Tante Molly had sprayed her hair with spray starch instead of hair. Mom washed her hair, giving her back a light brown color. She kissed her, wished her a good day, and sent her on her way. Tante Molly has given us a lifetime of smiles and wonderful memories. Even though we live across the country from each other now, we only lived across the street or next door to each other all my life. Tante Molly was like my second mother, Uncle Leo my second father, Sarah a second sister, and Ruby and Joey my only brothers. Our two families have shared good times and tragic times. From Sundays at Diamond and Cedar Lake, Bar Mitzvah's wedding, eating watermelon, Joey squishing his peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and Ruby rocking on the couch, to the devastating and untimely deaths in our families. Our two families have shared it all. The Rothsteins hold a special place in my heart and always will. I love you, Tante Molly, and I'm so sorry that I couldn't be with you to celebrate your 80th birthday. Please know that my heart and thoughts are with you. With much love and many kisses, Devil Up. And then I'll tell you mine real quick. Because I was thinking of all the things I had to tell about Grandma. And E.D. always came to mind, but that wasn't the story. But there was another real special day that I had, and it was my school 16th birthday. And I went over to Grandma and Grandpa's, because you always had to go there to get a gift. So we went over to Grandma and Grandpa's and we had dinner and we had to wait through all of the lunch and the meal that we had. And then Grandma said, "Are you ready for your sweet 16th birthday?" She'd been talking about it for weeks, what my gift was going to be.
This is tough.
And I said, "Okay, I'm ready." And she came out and she put around my neck the diamond pendant that I wear today. And it's always on me, and it's beautiful, and I thank you for calling. Happy birthday. Then there's Mr. B, which isn't exactly a grandma story, but it involves grandma. When I was little, how old was I? I don't know, I was very little.
Very, much little.
I was very young.
But not much smaller than you are now.
But not much smaller than I am now. And went over to Grandma and Grandma's house, and we had to be very quiet because Mr. B was sleeping.
What don't you want to get? Don't you want to get the main attraction on film at all?
We walked in the back, and that was where the back bedroom is, and where the kitchen and the dining, the kitchen table was at. And Mr. B was sleeping in the back bedroom, so be quiet. Okay. So go back into the house. We had our time, and an hour or two later, they said that Mr. B was done taking his nap, and he was out. Are coming up from the bedroom. And the next thing I knew, a dog came out of the bedroom.
A huge
dog came out of the bedroom, and I looked at my mom, I looked at Grandma, and said, "Mr. B, the dog ate Mr. B. The dog ate Mr. B." Mr. B was the dog. But that was the part I was missing.
Enjoy your Sundays and cake. And if anybody has anything to share, feel free to come on up here. This is, it's not as, you guys can take it as a story if you want, you know. Yeah, I'm going to just be talking to my grandma. When grandma, there's thousands of memories and good times. And you've been there all my life. And not only my grandma, you're a mother to me also. And there's one memory that just will stand in my mind forever.
Oh, I can't listen.
But the time that will remain in my mind is the most special time I've ever had in my life with you was when the first time you saw my son Leo and your first great grandchild. You just looked at me and you grabbed him and you looked at my wife Anna and you said, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And you said, mwah, 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 mwah. And we were so worried the baby wasn't breathing. But it was the most special, most happiest time of my life. And I'll never forget the way you looked, and the way you held me, and the way you held Leo, the way you held Leo's mom, Anna. And from myself and Anna and our kids back home and Leo, we love you very, very much. And may your husband's spirit, Leo, get passed on to my son, and may he be as good as a man as he was. May he rest in peace, and we all love you, and we wish you happy birthday, and we're going to be back here for your 90th birthday.
I'll make it 100.
No, we're going to Disney World forever.
But that's the really special time and story I have to say, is just watching you holding me up, you know, and that's it. I love you very much, and so does everyone else in this room. Because if it wasn't for you, no one else would be here, really. Thank you.
They did everything together.
The car was moving.
The car was moving.
instead of locking it, they open it. And my dad said, yeah, so I lock the door. So instead of pushing down, I push up.
Right.
And
go
there. Dad, son, play louder. What are you talking about?
And they all flew out after the purse. God forbid they should lose the purse.
Who was with me with that can of supposed peanuts that was worms? Were you with me? You remember that? She passed out? Go tell that story.
No, you tell the story. You tell it.
Okay, here's a cutie one.
She still, I don't think, remembers it. She woke up and doesn't remember, didn't remember it. We, with Sheila and a group of us, we had a can of said peanuts. And really inside was those worms that jumped out at you. And we threw all those scare mama. And she did. She came to the front parlor to go to open it for us. And she got it opened. And they jumped out. And she passed out.
Did she pass out?
We got so scared that our life would be over.
Sarah said she's dead.
But she came to it and didn't remember.
And she said, what did you do to me?
She said,
why
nothing.
Why did you do this?
Nothing.
Where's the movie?
Lion King! Wasn't that how they did it?
I got one more.
Okay.
Uh-oh. This isn't really about
my mom.
But then what's it about?
What are you doing?
This is about my brother and my sister.
Uh-oh.
And this is how they treated me when I was young.
My mom and from
from the Rothsteins and family and...
From the bottom of your heart.
Always. And we thank you for sharing this 80th birthday with Mom. It really, really means a lot. All the people came from out of town. Just everybody that's there. We love you very much, and just have a great time. Thanks a lot. Story time is not over yet.
If everyone's done talking, it is.
Really?
I can't remember.
Thank you very much for everybody come. I love everybody and I thank you for coming and celebrating to be the 80th birthday. Thank you. I love
you.
Thank you.
That's how much she loves everybody. She kissed the microphone.
My life would not be so complete. I wouldn't feel so good inside about who I am, about my family. So, thank you. Everybody loves you, and you love everybody, and I hope that you could.
Okay, I think that's going to wrap things up for today. And remember, if you drink, don't drive. Thank you.